So in past lectures, we have talked about a number of aspects. I think five aspects we have thoroughly seen in past lectures. So this is day number six, and in this particular day, or in this today's session, we are going to talk about one more aspect or two more aspects of a research proposal, and those two aspects are methods of data collection and tools or techniques which can be used for analysis of data purpose. Already we have taken small idea about methods of data collection in past lecture, and today I'm going to talk about those methods of collection in a precise manner. Even I'm going to talk on how to analyze the data. Basically, the data analysis process is actually there when you get approval from the university, when you collect your data, and when you start your work. At that time, that is useful for you guys. But I thought instead of not covering this one, why don't I cover some small part of data analysis so that you can have some idea about it. And this is my actual purpose of talking about data analysis. As I told you, when you write your research proposal, they do not expect you should be very much perfect in statistics, because nobody or everyone is not perfect in statistics. We have some certain limitations of our subject, because when we talk about education, in education there are so many branches, and it is not possible for all of us to get masters or mastery in all those branches. But we should have certain idea about that particular statistical tools which are used in the process of research. So this is what this is a small attempt which I'm making to make you aware about data analysis techniques. So अच्छा लेक्चर मध्ये आपण एक शेवटचा टॉपिक कव्हर करणार आहोत, आणि तो टॉपिक आहे मेथड ऑफ डेटा कलेक्शन्स. आणि जे काय आपण माहिती संकलित करणार आहोत, माहिती संकलन करण्याच्या पद्धती तो पहिला मुद्दा आहे. आणि दुसरा मुद्दा आहे की त्या माहिती जी संकलित करणार आहोत ती कशी आपण त्याचं विश्लेषण करणार आहोत, कोणकोणत्या साधनाचा वापर करणार आहोत, किंवा कशी विश्लेषित करणं किंवा त्याचं विश्लेषण कसं करणं अपेक्षित आहे, दॅट ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. सो दिस इज फॉर टुडेज सेशन, अँड आय एम ट्राईंग टू कव्हर ऑल दिस. Before going ahead, just I'm talking about the things which we have done. We have done five aspects of research proposal, and this one is the sixth one. If we complete this, you'll be able to write your proposal. I think so. If you are not able to, write, or if you have some difficulties, you can ask me your difficulties in days to come also. And let me tell you one thing before starting my session. If I start my session, there is a possibility of not reminding this. So our association is not there for this particular workshop. I will keep this association with you all in future also through this particular group. So I request you all to be there in a group, and not only be there in a group, but be there actively. You should be there in an active, mode, or always be there in the group. Active, show your active participation also. So whatever questions, whatever doubts you have, you can ask your doubts and questions by writing your post in the group, so that I can also answer your queries and doubts. And I hope you will also do the same things. So today we are talking about one more small aspect of research proposal, and that is methods of data collection and tools which are used for data analysis. So this is the highlight. This one is the main thing that we are discussing today. So before going to start the session, let me allow once again to share my screen and through this I'll show you my PPT. So is my PPT visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And is my voice and videos and AV is clear, means audio video clear?
Yes, both are clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So we are discussing about this particular things, which one is the little bit last part of your research proposal as far as major aspects are concerned. If you are able to find out certain methods which are suitable for your research, even if you are able to find out techniques of data analysis for your research proposal, then 100% I can say you guys have achieved the things which are required for writing your research proposal. And this one is a small attempt to make you aware about the method of data collection and technique of data analysis. So this is what this session is scheduled, and in this session also I have tried my level best to cover each and every aspect of research. Even I'm going to show you one demonstration on how to use SPSS, that is a software which we can use for research or data analysis in social sciences. So that is the SPSS stands for Software Package for Social Sciences, and that can be used for data analysis purpose. There are so many techniques that we can use for data analysis purpose. Whether your research is in Marathi or English doesn't matter. We can use this software for analysis of data that we collect in social sciences research. आता आपण या आजच्या लेक्चर मध्ये मेथड्स शिकणार आहोत, पण डेटा अनालिसिस कसा करावा ह्याचा सुद्धा आपण परिपूर्ण असा अभ्यास करण्याचा प्रयत्न करणार आहोत. त्याचप्रमाणे आजच्या लेक्चर मध्ये एक वेगळी गोष्ट म्हणजे मी तुम्हाला एसपीएसएस कसं वापरायचं त्याचे एक दोन डेमो तुम्हाला देणार आहेत. ऍक्च्युली एसपीएसएस इज अ व्हेरी ब्रॉड कॉन्सेप्ट अँड वी हॅव वी डोंट हॅव दॅट मच इनफ टाइम टू गो फॉर इच अँड एव्हरी ऍस्पेक्ट ऑफ SPSS. I'm planning one more workshop for understanding SPSS and how to use SPSS in social sciences research. That is my another model, and when you get your registration done, then you can register for that also. So very soon I'm starting one more workshop for SPSS purpose, but those who are already registered and doing their PhD, for them that is that much useful. If you want to join, you can also join. So this one is a things that we are discussing here. आज आपण या दोन गोष्टींबद्दल आवर्जून चर्चा करणार आहोत. सो आय एम स्टार्टिंग विथ माय प्रेझेंटेशन अँड द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज डिस्कशन इज मेथड्स ऑफ डेटा कलेक्शन एज वेल एज वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन वन मोर टॉपिक दॅट इज टेक्निक्स ऑफ डेटा अनालिसिस. या दोन गोष्टीवरती आपण प्रामुख्याने विचार करणार आहोत. तर बिफोर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टँड द डेटा कलेक्शन ऑलरेडी वी हॅव टॉक्ड अबाउट डेटा. वी वॉन्ट डेटा फॉर गोइंग फॉर अवर रिसर्च. इट मीन्स when we are at this particular stage of data analysis, certain things or certain assumptions are there. It means your topic is approved, even you guys have written your statement of problem, you guys have written your research hypothesis and research objectives also. So everything is done. Even you guys have thought about data research design, even methodology is also finalized, sampling is also done. And now, whatever sampling you guys have determined, on the basis of that sampling, you guys have decided to go for data collection. Now when you guys go for data collection, there are different methods of data collecting. So once you guys have decided to collect your data from your respondents, once the respondents are finalized, respondents are decided, then you guys have to think about the methods of data collection, how you are going to collect your data. So methods of data collections are decided on the basis of your respondents, on the basis of your nature of your study, even on the basis of sampling that you have done for your research. So there is a base for deciding the tools and methods of data collection. So me ja vales tumcha research hypothesis final hoto, objectives final hotat, samasya vidhan tumhi lihta, as good as tumhi baryachya goshti final kelele astat, and ja vales tumhala pudhe jaun data collect karat asto, karan data ja vales tumhi collect karta tya vales tumcha khara research suru hoto. So when you go for data, that thing is the research. ते खरं रिसर्च. त्यावेळेस तुम्ही रिसर्चला खरं म्हणतो काय म्हणतो आपण मध्यभागी आलेले असतात किंवा अशा स्टेजला असतं की तुम्हाला आता डेटा कलेक्शन करण्याची गरज आहे आणि तुमचे जे काही इन्फरन्सेस आहेत किंवा इंटरप्रिटेशन आहेत, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ अनालिसिस ऑफ डेटा यू विल राईट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डेटा कलेक्टेड. तुम्ही काही डेटा कलेक्ट करता त्यावरती तुम्ही तुमचं अनालिसिस करता, इन्फरन्सेस लिहिता आणि त्यानंतर तुम्ही यू मेक यू ड्रॉ युअर फाइंडिंग, यू राईट युअर सजेशन, यू राईट युअर कन्क्लुजन. सो यू आर ॲट द मिडल ऑफ द रिसर्च नाउ. When you think about collection of data, means you are in the middle of the research, or actual research would start. See, if you look at the previous topics, what topics we have, introductory part we go, then we go for literature review, then we go for writing research methodology, that you can do at home, but table work is required, I agree that. But when you want to enter into the field of research, when you enter in the field for collection of data, then actual research will start. So this is what I'm going to say. If you want to go for data collection, there are certain methods that you people have to choose for collection of your data, and how those methods are selected, those methods and tools are selected on the basis of certain parameters. So what are those parameters? You think about your title, you think about your research requirement, you think about your sampling, you think about your you think about your hypothesis and objectives also. Because you're going to collect your data on the basis of questionnaire you guys have decided. You're going to collect your data on the basis of techniques you guys have decided to collect the data. Suppose certain cases you need to collect the data by conducting interview. So this way, or certain in certain cases, it is must, it is required, because we cannot get data by using other forms of data collection. So interview is must. So you guys have to decide, see, this is my respondent, and for collecting data for this kind of respondent, this method is suitable. So you guys have to think after going through this particular lecture. And once again, I assure you guys, once we complete this particular lecture, you'll be able to understand which method is suitable for your respondent. I think everybody has to do one thing here before when we complete this. Till then, you guys have to think about your respondents. At the same time, you guys have to think about respondents, or what sort of respondents you are having in your research. You think about that, and simultaneously you go through the lecture. Automatically, you will be able to understand, yes, these are my respondents and these are the methods which are suitable for my research. इथं या लेक्चरमध्ये तुम्हाला माझी विनंती आहे की हे लेक्चर करत असतानाच तुम्ही तुमच्या जो काही टॉपिक आहे त्याच्यातले जे काही यु नो रिस्पॉन्डंट्स आहेत ते तुम्ही थोडे वेळापुरती तुम्ही फिक्स करा मनामध्ये. आणि जे तुम्ही रिस्पॉन्डंट फिक्स कराल आणि ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन तुम्हाला कळेल की हां हे माझे रिस्पॉन्डंट जर असेल किंवा हे माझे रिस्पॉन्डंट जर असतील तर मला ही मेथड तिथं वापरावी लागेल किंवा दुसरी कुठली तरी मेथड वापरावी लागेल. So this is, you know, the methods and tools of data collection. So the various steps of or strategies used for gathering and analyzing data in research investigations are known as the method of data collection. So whatever methods and tools we are using for collecting data in our research investigation, that particular or those particular methods and tools are called as methods of data collection. The simple meaning I have tried my level best to give you here in this slide. Then see techniques. Again, when we go for techniques, those are a little bit same, but the meaning is given in a different manner. The means of gathering data with the use of specific tools that are used in given method are known as techniques of data collection. Certain in certain research or certain research activity, we go for specific tools, especially statistical tools we use for data collections, or statistical or certain tools we go. Apart from our traditional tools that we or traditional methods that we use for data collection. So when we go for some specific tools in data collection, those tools are called as techniques of data collection. And tools for data collection, a research instruments is a device used to measure the concept of interest in a research project that the researchers use to collect the data. So certain cases, they create research instruments, they create research models also. In certain cases, especially for behavioral studies or in educational studies, for example, they go for certain sort of instrument. Even they develop a model, and through that particular model or through that particular instruments, they collect the data. But it is applicable for certain types of research, researchers only, not in every type of research in social sciences. There are techniques म्हणजे काय एक विशेष असे आपण टूल्स ठरवून ते वापरतो. काही केसेसमध्ये आपण मॉडेल्स डेव्हलप करतो, विशेषतः इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो फॉर स्टडी इन सायकोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट. सो इन सायकोलॉजी दे हॅव डिफरंट इन्स्ट्रुमेंट्स ऑर रिसर्च इन्स्ट्रुमेंट ऑर रिसर्च मॉडेल्स, अँड दे हॅव टू डेव्हलप दोज मॉडेल्स ऑर इन्स्ट्रुमेंट्स टू कलेक्ट द डेटा ऑर टू कंडक्ट देअर रिसर्च. सो इफ दे गो स्पेसिफिकली फॉर सर्टन सॉर्ट ऑफ इन्स्ट्रुमेंट्स अँड सर्टन सॉर्ट ऑफ मॉडेल्स इन रिसर्च, इट बिकम्स टूल्स फॉर डेटा कलेक्शन. बऱ्याच वेळा असं होतं, पण विशेषतः इन मॅनेजमेंट इन कॉमर्स ऑल्सो वी कॅन डेव्हलप इन्स्ट्रुमेंट्स, वी कॅन डेव्हलप मॉडेल्स ऑफ फॉर अवर रिसर्च, बट नॉट एव्हरी टाइम. इन सडन केसेस इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी, बट इट इज अप टू यू. इफ युअर टॉपिक डिमांड्स दॅट, देन यू कॅन गो फॉर इट ऑल्सो. बट अननेसेसरी यू डोंट गो फॉर एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ मॉडेल इन एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ इन्स्ट्रुमेंट टू कंडक्ट युअर रिसर्च ऑर टू अंडरटेक युअर रिसर्च. सो दिस इज फॉर कॉन्सेप्ट पार्ट. I hope you all are listening me. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a minute. Okay. So here, I think that day also I have shown this slide. And I gave an idea about the types of methods and techniques we have. We collect primary data as well as we collect secondary data. When it comes to primary data, these are the methods, and under these methods, these are the tools that we can use for collection of data. When we go for interview, accordingly tools are given. So here types of methods of data collection or techniques of data collections are given, and here in this column some tools are given. kindly go through this so that you'll be able to understand. There is no problem as such. You can go through this and you'll be, or you will have a proper understanding of these tools that we can use for different types of methods that we use in under the category of primary data collection. So see, in previous lecture we guys have talked about primary data and secondary data. So that I have, you know, covered in that lecture, and this one is not taken here in this methods of data collection. So there are two methods of data collection, primary data collection, sorry, there are two ways of data collection, primary data collection and second data collection. So I'm not repeating that, already we have seen. So we are talking about the methods of data collection in case of primary data sources, or we are going to talk about methods of data collection in case of secondary data sources. So this one is the, you know, highlight. Basic part we have done in previous lecture, I think research number lecture number 4, we guys have talked about that. So this one is the interview method. In case of primary data collection, there are different methods, but out of those methods, we are considering first one, that is interview. In certain cases, as I told you, data is not collected through, secondary sources, but we need to have first-hand data. We want first-hand data. We cannot get that data in published or unpublished sources. For example, if I refer some journals, those things are not available. So what should I go? What should I do? I have to go for primary sources. Primary sources means what? Those are also called as first-hand sources. First-hand means what? We are collecting information from those people first-hand, and we are the first beneficiary of that information. So that information is not, given by that particular person to anyone else, or that is not in the form of publication, or in the form of journal, in the form of article. So if you want to get this kind of data, that data can be collected through interview or conducting interview. So interview method is the first method of data collection under primary data sources. So through this interview, we collect whatever data we want. So accordingly, you guys have to make a schedule of interview for that particular person or for that concerned person. And you have to collect data according to the responses issued during the interview. So this is interview method. There are different types of interviews can be conducted to collect the data under the primary data sources. What are they? Now here, there is no need to tell you the meaning of interview. Interview is a method of collecting the data from person or interviewer. We ask some questions and that particular person has to answer those questions, and answer of that particular person are called as responses. So on the basis of responses received from the that particular person whose interview we are conducting, is called as data collected or responses collected. We analyze those responses, and on the basis of analysis done, on the basis of responses, we go for inferences, we go for interpretation, and on the basis of inferences, we write conclusion, we write our suggestions, and so on. So here, if you want to go for interview as a method of primary data collection, so there are different types of interviews that we can conduct. So I think you guys are also aware of the types of interviews that we conduct for different purposes, and we appear for the interview also, and we conduct the interview also. And when we go through news channels and all, there also they conduct interview. So n number of types of interviews are there, and we conduct different types of interviews for the purpose of data collection. आपण मुलाखत घेतो, मुलाखतीचे खूप प्रकार आहेत. बेसिकली मुलाखतीमध्ये जे काय आपण प्रश्न विचारतो आणि त्याचे जे काय आन्सर्स असतात, ते आपले रिस्पॉन्सेस असतात, आणि त्याच्या बेसिसवरती आपण आपला इन्फरन्सेस किंवा विश्लेषण करून आपण निरीक्षणे नोंदवत असतो, त्यानंतर आपण सूचना देत असतो, त्यानंतर आपण काय म्हणतो निष्कर्ष लिहित असतो. या सर्वांसाठी तुम्हाला डेटा लागणार आहे, आणि तो जो काही डेटा लागणार आहे तो आपण वेगवेगळ्या पद्धतीतून मागवून घेणार आहोत किंवा वेगवेगळ्या पद्धतीने आपण कलेक्ट करणार आहोत. तर दिस इज वॉट एन नंबर ऑफ मेथड ऑफ प्रायमरी डेटा कलेक्शन आर देअर. सो दिस वन इज द फर्स्ट वन, दॅट इज इंटरव्ह्यू मेथड. मुलाखत पद्धत ही एक पहिली पद्धत आहे. मुलाखतीचे खूप प्रकार आहेत दॅट वी कॅन यूज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ डेटा कलेक्शन. हॅलो हॅलो
येस सर.
पीपीटी दिसत नव्हतं ना?
नाही सर, दिसते.
ओके ओके, मला ते टॅब दिसत नाही बरं का, हाईड झालं माहिती नाही. ओके, पण पीपीटी दिसते ना?
येस सर, येस सर.
Okay, जर दिसत नसेल तर प्लीज सांगा, अदरवाइज यू नो व्हाट विल हॅपन, आय विल ओनली टॉक. सो सी
यस सर, डेफिनेटली
सो देर आर डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ इंटरव्ह्यूज दॅट वी कंडक्ट फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ डेटा कलेक्शन. आपण आपल्या डेटा कलेक्शनसाठी खूप साऱ्या इंटरव्ह्यू पद्धतीचा वापर करू शकतो, पण ते तुम्हाला ठरवायचे विच वन इज द बेस्ट वन. मोस्टली पीपल गो फॉर द फर्स्ट वन. बऱ्याच केसेसमध्ये, बऱ्याच रिसर्चमध्ये असं आढळून आलंय, इन मोस्ट ऑफ द रिसर्च स्टडीज पीपल गो फॉर स्ट्रक्चर्ड इंटरव्ह्यू. Structured interview means what? The questions that you want to ask to interviewers are, you know, already scheduled, already made by the person who is conducting interview or interviewee. So here we go for structured one. So questions are already decided, and on the basis of those decided questions, there is an interview, and that kind of interview is also called what? Face-to-face interview. We conduct that. Then unstructured interview, then semi-structured. Means some part is structured, some part is not structured. At 11th hour, some questions are asked by according to the responses received from the person. Then focused group interview. Sometimes group interview is also conducted. If it is not possible to go for face to face, then we go for face to face, but calling a group of people for answering the questions or getting with their responses. Then in certain cases, I think we are in pandemic from last 1.5 years. आपण दीड वर्षापासून साधारणपणे पॅन्डेमिक मध्ये आहोत. आपण कुठे बाहेर जाऊ शकत नाही, गेलो तरी सोशल डिस्टन्सिंग आहे. त्यानंतर बरेचसे यु नो आपल्याकडे रिस्ट्रिक्शन्स आहेत. सो इन दॅट केस वी कॅन गो फॉर इंटरव्ह्यू विच इज कंडक्टेड थ्रू टेलिफोनिक इंटरव्ह्यू. अँड इन कॉर्पोरेट इट इज द मोस्ट युजुअल प्रॅक्टिस, दे कंडक्ट देअर इंटरव्ह्यूज थ्रू टेलिफोन. So as far as our research is concerned, we can also go for it. If it is not possible to visit that particular place, so we can schedule telephonic interview for collecting the data. So these are the types of interviews that you can conduct for conducting or completing your research activities. So this one is the process. If you go through this process, definitely you will be able to complete your interview process. So please go through all these slides. Today the number of slide is very huge, because I have covered everything. I have not left anything else to I have not tried anything else to hide. Then questionnaire method, this one is the most commonly used method of conducting research. Okay, is everything okay? Am I audible and my PPT is visible?
Yes sir.
Okay, so yeah. this one is a questionnaire method. As I told you, this questionnaire method is commonly used in research. Mostly out of, for example, if there are 100 people, so out of those 100, 99 people, they go for questionnaire. Not only this one is a single method of collecting primary data, people go for 2-3 methods of collecting primary data also. People go for interview, people go for questionnaire, people go for scheduling also. And in a research, you can also go for 2-3 types of methods of primary data sources. It is not mandatory to go for only one source of primary data collection. You can opt 2-3 methods of primary data collection. There is no issue at all. Then moving, try to understand questionnaire means what. We go for, we design some questions according to the requirement of your study, according to the requirement of on the basis of your hypothesis and on the basis of your objectives. So there is my suggestion to all of you. When you are there to design a questionnaire, most of the time people, they don't think about the questionnaire. They make questionnaire and they write unnecessary questions, irrelevant questions in their question. So how to design a question, that I will tell you. बऱ्याच वेळा आपण प्रश्नावली तयार करत असतो ना, त्यावेळेस प्रश्नावली तयार करत असताना आपण काही चुका करतो. तर प्रश्नावली कशी तयार करावी? क्वेश्चनर कॅन बी डिझाईन्ड बाय कीपिंग सम पॉईंट्स इन युअर माइंड. सो व्हॉट आर दोज पॉईंट्स? यू गाइज हॅव टू थिंक अबाउट ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह ऑफ युअर रिसर्च. यू गाइज हॅव टू थिंक अबाउट युअर हायपोथिसिस ऑफ रिसर्च. And you guys have to think about the sampling which you have decided for your research. If you think about these three aspects of your research study, and if you make your questionnaire, automatically you get a desired result that you want. And most of the time what happens, people get highly confused. I'm using this word here, highly confused, while designing questionnaire. Because designing a questionnaire is not that much easy task. See, whatever I'm showing today, this one is not that much useful for research proposal, but these are the things which are useful for your, actual research. So I'm giving some hints. How to design a questionnaire? Questionnaire designing is a, not that much simple task. Remember, it is very important one, and it is very, you know, time consuming also. So how it can be decided? So one funda is there while we go for designing of questionnaire. So that funda you remember, or you will remember me at that time of when you go for your questionnaire. मला नक्की वाटतं की तुम्ही ज्यावेळेस तुमचे क्वेश्चनेअर बनवाल फायनल रिसर्चचे, सध्या तरी तुम्हाला काही कुठे लिहायचं नाही किंवा बनवायचं नाही आहे, फक्त मी तुम्हाला आयडिया असं म्हणून सांगतोय. पण ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही क्वेश्चनेअर बनवाल त्यावेळेस माझे हे तुम्हाला शब्द आठवतील, यू रिमेंबर माय सेंटेन्स. सो क्वेश्चनर विल बी डिझाईन्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वॉट, और क्वेश्चनर विल डिझाईन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ थ्री मेजर फॅक्टर्स. क्वेश्चनेअर्स बनवत असताना तुम्हाला तीन गोष्टी सतत कम्पेअर करायचे, सतत त्याचा रेफरन्स घ्यायचा आहे. फर्स्ट वन इज वॉट? रिसर्च ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. सेकंड वन इज वॉट? रिसर्च हायपोथेसिस. अँड थर्ड वन इज वॉट? The sampling, because you are going to collect the data from your samples. So samples are also considered at the time of designing questionnaire. Objectives are also considered at the time of designing questionnaire. Even hypotheses are also considered at the time of questionnaire. Why it is so? See, you are going to write your hypothesis based on the objectives, and accordingly you decide your sample size. So see, whatever you want to achieve, that is there in the objectives. That is there in the hypothesis. Whatever you want to prove, that is there in the hypothesis. And if you set, if you write, if you design irrelevant questions in the questionnaire, your hypothesis will not be proved, your objectives will not be achieved. And if you go for such kind of questionnaire, you get unnecessary data which is not useful for your research. Tumhi questionnaires karat astana objective varti focus kara, tyanantar hypothesis varti focus kara, karan yas goshti tumhala pudhe jaun sangayche. तुम्हाला ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह शेवटी एक असतं, वेदर द ऑब्जेक्ट रिसर्च ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह आर अचीव्ड ऑर नॉट, त्यासाठी तुम्हाला एक पॅराग्राफ लिहायचा असतो. आणि तुम्ही कसं लिहिणार जर तुम्ही ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह बेस्ड क्वेश्चनेअर तयार केले नसेल तर? आणि जर तुम्ही ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह बेस्ड क्वेश्चनेअर तयार केले नसेल तर तुम्ही जे काही हायपोथिसिस मांडलेले आहेत ते कसे प्रूव्ह करणार, त्याचं टेस्टिंग कसं करणार? नाही होऊ शकणार. सो दिस इज वॉट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टेस्ट युअर हायपोथिसिस, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रूव्ह युअर हायपोथिसिस, युअर क्वेश्चनेअर शुड बी बेस्ड ऑन द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एज वेल एज युअर क्वेश्चनेअर शुड बी बेस्ड ऑन द हायपोथिसिस. Even you guys have to think about the sampling while going for the designing your question. So questionnaire designing is the most important aspect, and most of the researchers, they don't have enough knowledge and they set irrelevant questions and they get into trouble in future while they go for actual research. Tanna batita daun kalta ja vela apan kadi kalta maite ka aple questionnaire chukliye kadi kalta ja vela apan analysis la jato analysis la basto tya vela aplyala kalta ki are ha mi question ugich vicharlay. याच्यामधून तर कुठलेच ऑब्जेक्टिव स्पष्ट होत नाही, कुठलंच हायपोथिसिस प्रूव्ह होत नाही. सो दॅट इज व्हेरी डेंजरस. आणि हे कधी कळतं? अडीच वर्षांनी, दोन वर्षांनी, की आपण काहीतरी चुकीचं करून बसलो आणि मग त्यावेळेस वेळ कमी असतो, मग आपण थोडं फ्रस्ट्रेशनमध्ये येतो. अँड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू अवॉइड ऑल दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ फ्रस्ट्रेशन, वेक अप अर्ली, थिंक अबाउट द क्वेश्चनर्स, अँड इफ यू हॅव एनी प्रॉब्लम रिमेंबर मी अँड कॉल मी ऑन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर डे, आय बी देअर टू हेल्प यू आउट, नो इश्यू. Then here are some types of questionnaires. So in questionnaire we go for basically two types of questions, and those two types of questions are open format of questions, which is also called as open ended question. Marathi ke lokana sudha apan bolu shakto ki don prakarche questions apan avarjun takto. There are n number of types of questions that can be inserted into the question, but basically we go for two types of questions. आपण म्हणतो, मी तुम्हाला कालच सांगितलं की आय थिंक एका लेक्चर मध्ये मी तुम्हाला बोललो की दोन प्रकारचे प्रश्न असतात, स्टडी कुठलाही असू दे, अभ्यास कुठलाही असू द्या. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन्स दॅट वी ऑलवेज फॉलो. वन इज डब्ल्यू एच क्वेश्चन्स, द क्वेश्चन विच स्टार्ट्स विथ डब्ल्यू अँड एच, दॅट इज डब्ल्यू एच क्वेश्चन्स. अँड दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन विच स्टार्ट्स विथ डब्ल्यू एच एन डब्ल्यू अँड एच, दोज कॅन बी कॉल्ड एज ओपन एंडेड. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, वॉट आर द रिझन्स ऑफ कंडक्टिंग रिसर्च? So you write whatever you want, and there is an option for everyone else, and everybody's answer will be different. If I ask you this question and if write your answer, everybody's answer will be different, because everybody's objective behind conducting the research is different. So there is a space, there is a chance for the respondent to write their own opinion, to write their own views when we ask open ended question or open format question. So there is one more logic, or one more way to find out whether it is open ended or closed ended. The question which starts with W and H is open ended. Remember this much. And mostly rarely we go for open ended question in the questionnaire. And these are the examples of open ended question. If you go through this, you can understand the concept of open ended question. Then closed ended question. So there is no chance for the respondent to write their opinions and views, because there is a restriction. What sort of restriction is there? So these questions are also called as what, yes-no type questions. So you have to give your answer in the form of yes or no. So these are the two options only in front of you. And whatever question I asked, you guys have to answer in the form of yes, either yes or no. So there is a restriction, and this kind of questions can be called as what, closed-ended or closed format that you can ask. See, we write this kind of questions in the questionnaire also. Are you married or not? Are you married? We write yes, no. So if I am married, I will have to write yes. If not, then write no. So these are the two options. Okay. So there is no option like this, willing to marry, going to marry, like that. So this option is not there. So there are only two options, and those two options are yes or no. And this kind of questions can be called as closed-ended or yes-no type questions. Here are some examples. Have you ever been hospitalized? We can answer this question in two formats only. That is yes or no. If it is hospitalized, yes. If no, no. So these are the examples. The multiple choice questions that we all are using nowadays for conducting exams. So there are options, four options. Sometimes there are five options. There are some, in certain cases, there are three options. Bahu paryayi prashna apan tyala manto. Char options apan detoy. And tya char paiki tyala ek choose karayacha asto. Ashe prakarche prashna apan aplya questionnaire madhe suddha vapru shakto. We can use this kind of questions in our questionnaire. But understand the need of the question, understand the need of the study, and then write the question. Cafeteria questions. So here certain things are given. Examples are given here. So one statement is given, and accordingly we guys have to respond, give our response for the question. Rank order questions. There is a rank. You guys have to give the rank. All answers are suitable. All answers are same. All answers are correct, by the way. Sorry, not same. All answers are correct, but you have to give them a rank. So this way it is, these questions are asked. If you look at the example, what according to you is most important for your life? See, if I ask you this question, your answers will be, all answers are correct. According to me, money is important, education is important, family is also important, health is also important. But somebody asked me to rank the most important answer out of this, then everybody will do according to their choice. So answers are correct. All answers are correct. Nothing is wrong. No answer is wrong. But priority is different. Everybody's priority is different. According to everyone, importance is also different. So we get different answers. And this kind of questions can be called as rank order questions. प्रत्येकाची प्रायोरिटी वेगळी असते. प्रत्येकाचं रँकिंग करण्याची पद्धत वेगळी असते. कुणासाठी पैसा जरूरी आहे, कुणासाठी शिक्षण जरूरी आहे, कुणासाठी फॅमिली जरूरी आहे, कुणासाठी हेल्थ जरूरी आहे. आपण परिस्थितीनुसार निर्णय घेत असतो. परिस्थितीनुसार आपल्या प्रायोरिटी सुद्धा बदलतात. परिस्थितीनुसार आपल्या प्रायोरिटीज बदलत जातात. जी प्रायोरिटी आपल्या एज मध्ये असते ते 50 नंतर असू शकत नाही. ऍट दॅट पर्टिक्युलर स्टेज वी थिंक अबाउट अवर हेल्थ. ऍट द एज ऑफ 35 और 35 टू 50 वी थिंक अबाउट अवर फॅमिली. ऍट द एज ऑफ 15 टू 25 वी थिंक अबाउट अवर एज्युकेशन. अँड वेन वी गेट इन टू द जॉब वी थिंक अबाउट अर्निंग मनी. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द एज अवर प्रायोरिटी चेंजेस. सो दिस इज वॉट इफ वी आस्क क्वेश्चन्स वी गेट डिफरंट आन्सर्स. All those answers are correct, but here we are asking them to rank. If I ask you to rank these four answers according to your priority, if I look at the age of the people, they go for different, you know, order also. प्रत्येकाचे ऑर्डर बदलेल. काही लोक मनीला पहिले ऑर्डर देतील, दुसऱ्याला एज्युकेशनला दुसरे देतील, असंही होऊ शकेल. इट इज अप टू यू गाईज टू प्रोव्हाइड एन ऑर्डर, अँड वेन इट इज प्रोव्हाइडेड इट इज कॉल्ड व्हॉट, रँक ऑर्डर. Then contingency questions. It means what? Here, I think we also ask some questions. Here, contingency is there. Contingency means what? If you're going to say something yes, look at the example. By looking at the example, you'll be able to understand everything, or you can understand everything. Do you have children under 18 at home? If you say no, then next question is not applicable for you. If you say yes, then next question is applicable for you. See, if I say yes, then after the yes, what is written? If yes, please list ages. If you say no, there is no need to list the ages. But if you say yes, definitely you need to write something more. For example, if I write like this in registration form of the workshop, are you interested to pay or have you paid the amount for workshop? If you say yes, then I say like this, then click on the WhatsApp link. If you say no, no question of clicking on the WhatsApp link to join the group. So this kind of question is called what? Quantitative questions. We ask, see, upon the Rasa Prashna which are last seal, if we are doing family related studies. For example, we ask one question. Upon Rasa Prashna which are like, are you married? Me, Vibhaita hai ka? Kita apun yes ani no thevle. If somebody says yes, then our related question is, contingency question is, how many children you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. If somebody is saying no, so there is no question of writing children like that. So this kind of questions can be called as contingency questions. Rating order. So see, we also basically when we go for apun jya vele ekada vartanacha abhyas karat asto kiwa ekada marketing cha balas vela apun abhyas karto kiwa ekada tendency cha abhyas karat asto or when we go for a study which shows a sort of tendency, so there we go for this kind of rating scale. There are n number of rating scale, but one scale is very much popular in research activities, that is Likert scale or Likert scale, that also I'm going to show you. So here scale is given and we provide that scale. Basically when we go to attend the seminar and the workshop, they provide one sheet at the last session and they ask you to give feedback in rating form. So rating is given. How was the workshop? As far as hospitality is concerned, rate your scale. Poor, very good, poor, okay, good, every good, or very good, like that. So accordingly we write. If we feel okay, then we write okay. So rating is done here. And these kind of questions are used in the research activities also, or in your questionnaire also. Then important questions. We ask them to show their importance from the below given points. And accordingly, we provide our importance. Exercising every day is dash for the health. Accordingly, we write. See, if I ask you this question, you will put according to your requirement. Somebody, they are not, giving time for exercising. Somebody, they are giving huge time for exercising. If you look at the celebrities, 4 or 5 hours they are spending in gym for exercise. So everybody's preference, everybody's priority is different. And answer will be also different if we ask some questions. And if answers are the same, it is difficult to go for analysis. And this is what we are using. This kind of questions in the research to go for the right analysis. As I told you, this one is the Likert scale or Likert questions. Likert questions, we cannot say. Likert scale is there, which is designed by one management professional. That is Likert. And that scale, which is designed by him, is called as Likert scale. And when we go for behavioral study or study related to management, even in finance also, we use this, or in education also, we use this scale. Upon high education, we use the scale of approach. So, do upon questionnaire design can be set. Dilella hai. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is. आवाज आता एकदम छोटा होता. कैसा मधे?
तुम्ही जो हम आगे गया था, तेरे मधे क्या सडनली वॉल्यूम एकदम बारीक होता.
Okay. मैं आता अरेंगलर्स नहीं. Okay. थोड़ा सा मूव होतो है. करेक्ट. ओके, तर लिकर्ट स्केल आहे. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज लिकर्ट स्केल एंड हियर दे वी गो फॉर 5 ऑप्शन्स. एक्चुअली देयर आर 2 टाइप्स ऑफ स्केल्स व्हिच इज डेव्हलप्ड बाय लिकर्ट. फर्स्ट वन इज 5 पॉइंट स्केल. हियर यू कैन सी 5 पॉइंट्स और 5 आंसर्स. एंड सेकंड वन इज 7 पॉइंट स्केल. 7 पॉइंट स्केल इज ऑल्सो डेव्हलप्ड और इन्वेंटेड बाय लिकर्ट. So people, mostly people go for 5-point scale. Even you can also go for 7-point scale. But when we use 7-point scale in questionnaire and when we go for analysis, so using 7-point scale for analysis is a little bit difficult for the researchers to analyze the data. This is what most of the researchers, they don't go for 7-point. But 7-point scale is also there. So choice is yours, which one should opt at the time of designing your questionnaire. Sorry. दोन प्रकारचे स्केल लिकर्टनी डेव्हलप केलेत. पहिला आहे 5 पॉइंटचा आणि दुसरा आहे 7 पॉइंटचा. तर असेच त्याच्यामध्ये आन्सर्स आहेत. जसे की आपण स्ट्रॉंगली अग्री अनसर्टन, दिस अनसर्टन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड न्यूट्रल, डिसअग्री, स्ट्रॉंगली डिसअग्री, अशा प्रकारचे स्केल आहेत. हा 5 पॉइंट स्केल झाला, 5 पॉइंट स्केल झाला आणि जो दुसरा आहे तो 7 पॉइंट स्केल आहे. त्याच्यामध्ये दोन पर्याय जे असतात, आणि त्याच्याप्रमाणे आपण सुद्धा स्केल करू शकतो. पण माझं एक ऑब्झर्वेशन असं आहे की आय डू इवन आय डील विथ रिसर्च अनालिसिस. सो मोस्टली आय फाउंड दॅट पीपल गो फॉर 5 पॉईंट स्केल इन्स्टेड ऑफ गोईंग फॉर 7 पॉईंट स्केल बिकॉज ऑफ दे डोंट वॉन्ट एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ यु नो हेड एक ॲट द टाइम ऑफ अनालिसिस ऑफ युअर डेटा. सो दिस इज वॉट पीपल गो फॉर Likert's 5-point scale. And mostly we get, you know, questions in questionnaire in Likert's 5-point scale. So these are the ways of conducting or collecting methods of questionnaire administration. Whatever questions you guys have designed that can be administered by using this ways. We send question by using postal services. आपण questionnaire सुद्धा questionnaire पाठवू शकतो आणि त्यांना ते परत भरून झाल्यानंतर परत पाठवायला सांगू शकतो. कोणी सुद्धा आपण त्यांना एक एक प्रश्न विचारून त्यांचे आन्सर्स आपण इकडे करू शकतो. बट वी शुड बी व्हेरी मच एथिकल वाईल पुटिंग द टिक मार्क्स. नाही तर त्याने एक वेगळंच उत्तर दिलं आणि आपण वेगळीकडे स्टिक करतोय असं नको व्हायला. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आपण बऱ्याच वेळेस आपल्या सोयीने टिक मार्क करण्यासाठी सांगत असतो. दॅट इज ऑल्सो नॉट गुड. इन दॅट केस वी वोंट गेट ऍक्च्युअल रिझल्ट ऑर ऍक्च्युअल रिस्पॉन्सेस फ्रॉम द रिस्पॉन्डंट्स. लोकांना त्यांच्या मनाप्रमाणे करू द्या. फक्त त्यांना क्वेश्चनियर काय आहे आणि कसं लिहायचं किंवा आन्सर कसे द्यायचे त्यांना एकदा समजावून सांग. कारण लोकांना एवढा वेळ नसतो. शक्यतो क्वेश्चनर ही छोटी बनवा. जास्तीत जास्त 20 क्वेश्चन पेक्षा जास्त क्वेश्चन टाकू नका. इफ यू राईट मोर दॅन 20 क्वेश्चन इफ यू आर मेकिंग युअर क्वेश्चनर ऑफ 5 पेजेस ऑर 6 पेजेस इट शुड बी ऑफ मॅक्सिमम 2 पेजेस बिकॉज पीपल दे डोंट हॅव इनफ टाइम टू फिल युअर क्वेश्चनर ऑफ 5 पेजेस ऑर 6 पेजेस. 6-5 पेजेस क्वेश्चनर फिल करण्यासाठी लोकांसाठी एवढा वेळ नाही आहे. तुम्हाला ते अर्धा तास पाऊन तास नाही देऊ शकत. जास्तीत जास्त 10 मिनिट तुम्हाला देऊ शकतात. हे हार्डली आपण बघतोय आज जस्ट खूप फास्ट झाले. सो अकॉर्डिंगली यू ऑल्सो थिंक अबाउट दॅट. देन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वे ऑफ गेटिंग ऑर देर इज वन मोर वे दॅट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वे ऑफ क्वेश्चनियर ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. सो यू कॅन सेंड युअर क्वेश्चनियर थ्रू ईमेल. देर इज वन यु नो फॅसिलिटी विच इज गिव्हन बाय गुगल दॅट वी कॅन यूज. हो करेक्ट. अँड द नेक्स्ट वन इज पर्सनली ऍडमिनिस्टर्ड. We can directly contact our respondents. We can directly ask them to fill the questionnaire by sitting with them, or we can have face-to-face interaction and we can ask them to fill the data. So these are the ways to administer your questionnaire. Now observation method. Already we have seen that the questionnaire method khoop jaast pramanat vaparli jate manun tyachyavarti mi khoop changla padhyane sangat prayatna kela aahe. मी म्हणणार नाही की चांगलं सांगितलं पण चांगल्या पद्धतीने सांगण्याचा प्रयत्न केलाय. नाव वी ऑल्सो गो फॉर ऑब्झर्वेशन मेथड. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली प्रायमरी डेटा कलेक्शन सोर्सेस. आपण अजूनही प्रायमरी डेटा कलेक्शन सोर्सेस बद्दलच बोलतोय. अजून सेकंडरी सोर्सेसला यायचंय. देन ऑब्झर्वेशन मेथड्स वी गो फॉर ऑब्झर्वेशन. वी स्टार्ट ऑब्झर्विंग द पीपल अँड वी राईट आवर रिस्पॉन्सेस ऑर वी पुट मार्क्स फॉर आवर रिस्पॉन्सेस. आपण आपल्या रिस्पॉन्सेससाठी टिक मार्क करत असतो लोकांना ऑब्झर्व करून. आपल्याला माहिती नसते की आपल्याला लोक ऑब्झर्व करतात पण वी कॅन ऑब्झर्व. एक काम करा तुम्ही सुद्धा कधी कधी बसल्या जर तुम्ही कधी रेल्वे स्टेशनला असाल बस स्टँडला असाल तर फक्त एक 10 मिनिट लोकांना ऑब्झर्व करा. खूप लोक खूप वेगळ्या प्रकारचे लोक असतात आणि त्याला तुम्हाला खूप आनंद मिळेल. फक्त वेळ काढून ठरवायचं आता मी फक्त 10 मिनिट लोकांना ऑब्झर्व करणार. प्रत्येकाला ऑब्झर्व करायचं हाऊ दे बिहेव. सो दॅट इज अ सर्टन टाईप ऑफ मेथड ऑफ ऑब्झर्विंग पीपल. सो हिअर सर्टन यु नो थेरॉटिकल आस्पेक्ट्स आर गिवन हाऊ इट इज emerged, how the origin of the word observe is also given. Just go through this at home. And this one is a conceptual part and it will make your conceptual study perfect. So these are the types of observations that we can use for the purpose of observing people or observing your respondents, by the way. Instead of saying people, I must say observing your respondents. So structured observations are there, unstructured observation, participant observation. You can participate in that particular group and you can observe them. Then non-participant observation. Basically people do not go for, or researchers do not go for observation. It is very time consuming. And see what happens if they understand you are observing them, they behave something different. त्यावेळेस लोकांना कळतं की तुम्ही त्यांना ऑब्झर्व करायला लागलात किंवा ऑब्झर्व करतायत त्यावेळेस ते यु नो स्टार्ट बिहेविंग व्हेरी डिप्लोमॅटिकली. And that is not good for the research. So most of the people, I have not seen any example so far, those who have taken this method for primary data collection. So, but you can go for this also. Basically, it is possible, हे बऱ्याच वेळा psychological ज्या studies असतात त्याच्यामध्ये हे बऱ्याच वेळा ही पद्धत वापरली जाते. But when it comes to, you know, management, when it comes to, even in management also, it is possible. because most of the management theorems are given or theories are given by observing the people. Whatever management thinkers we guys have studied, they have given their theories. Like, you know, Maslow's need hierarchy theory and XY theory. So many theories are there in management, and those are based on observation, based on certain experiments. ते आधारावरती आहेत किंवा इव्हन एज्युकेशन मध्ये थेरी सुद्धा त्याला सुद्धा हा थोडासा बेस आहे. पण हा बेस मला एक कोणीही वापरलेला अजूनपर्यंत दिसला नाही, पण तुम्ही वापरू शकता. आणि मी सांगितल्याप्रमाणे ह्या थोडेसे लिमिटेशन आहेत. वेन जेव्हा आपल्या लोकांना कळतं, वेन वी वेन दे आर दे यु नो रिअलाइज दॅट वी आर ऑब्झर्विंग देम, देन ओनली दे डेफिनेटली ट्राय टू शो दॅट हाऊ दे आर समथिंग डिफरंट अँड दे स्टार्ट बिहेविंग डिप्लोमॅटिकली. तर असं होऊ शकतं, त्यामुळं शक्यतो इतर बायस्ड व्ह्यू देऊ शकतात, किंवा आपण म्हणतो ना जे रिझल्ट आपल्याला अपेक्षित आहेत ते येऊ शकत नाहीत. दिस वॉट दिस इज नॉट दॅट मच सुटेबल. सो हिअर द मेथड्स ऑफ ऑब्झर्वेशन आर गिवन इन वॉट कॅन बी डन अंडर दोज मेथड्स. दे हॅव कॅटेगरीज ऑफ ऑब्झर्वेशन अँड मेथड्स दॅट कॅन बी यूज फॉर ऑब्झर्वेशन विच वी हॅव गिवन हिअर. जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस. इवन वी कॅन ऑब्झर्व देम बाय युझिंग टेक्नॉलॉजी. Nowadays, we can see so many types of boards. You are under CCTV surveillance and all. So that is a good way of observing people. If they are that much perfect, आपल्याला CCTV observe करते, again they behave very diplomatically. Then rating scales are also used. Rating scale सुद्धा आपण वापरू शकतो. Rating scale काय आहे, त्याच्यात इथं दिलेलं आहे. या रेटिंग स्केलच्या मेथड्स आहेत, ग्राफिक रेटिंग स्केल, डिस्क्रिप्टिव्ह रेटिंग स्केल, न्यूमरिकल रेटिंग स्केल, कम्पेरेटिव्ह रेटिंग स्केल. या सगळे स्केल रेटिंग स्केल वापरून तुम्ही रेटिंग करू शकता. त्याच्यावरती तुमचे डेटा कलेक्ट होऊ शकतो आणि तो डेटा तुम्ही अनालाइज करू शकता. ग्राफिक स्केल कसे बघा, आपण इथं एक त्यांना स्केल ठरवलेली आहे. वी हॅव वन स्केल विथ अस अँड दॅट स्केल इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड व्हॉट लायकर्ट स्केल अगेन, लिकर्ट स्केल अगेन, दॅट कॅन बी यूज्ड. डिस्क्रिप्टिव्ह स्केल, आपण त्यांना एक डिस्क्रिप्टिव्ह शीट देऊ शकतो अँड यू कॅन गेट द रिस्पॉन्सेस बाय गेटिंग द रिस्पॉन्सेस इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर डिस्क्रिप्टिव्ह शीट. देन न्यूमरिकल स्केल, देर इज वन स्केल न्यूमरिकल, सो वी आस्क देम टू राईट द रिस्पॉन्सेस इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर स्केल ओनली. देन चेकलिस्ट, वी आस्क देम टू वी मेक अ लिस्ट ऑफ आयटम विच इज कॉल्ड अ चेकलिस्ट अँड अकॉर्डिंगली वी आस्क सम क्वेश्चन्स. दिस वन इज द प्रोसिजर टू conduct a checklist or conduct a research or conduct or collect the information through checklist. The information sathi sangto tumhala. So this way we collect the data. Now one part is left, that is second data. How to collect the second data? It is very simple. We collect second data through published and unpublished sources. When we go for when we have information in the form of statistical data, so we go for n number of published and unpublished sources. We refer government reports, we refer government GR, we refer publications. If you are doing your PhD in finance, so we need to refer government's publication, we need to refer RBI publications and all. So that is called as second data. And sometimes we want both types of data for our research. So we go for primary data as well as second data. Primary data madhe aplyala methods pahile, apan second data madhe methods as kay nahi, je kay uplabdh ahe, ते काही पब्लिश आहेत, पब्लिकेशन्स आहेत, जर्नल्स आहेत, आर्टिकल्स आहेत. त्यानंतर तुम्ही समजा बँकाचा स्टडी करताय, फायनान्शियल परफॉर्मन्स अनालिसिसचा, तर ते काही रिपोर्ट्स आहेत, त्यांचे बॅलन्स शीट्स आहेत, अकाउंटिंग स्टेटमेंट्स आहेत. दोज कॅन बी ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ यु नो डेटा अनालिसिस अँड दॅट इज युअर सेकंड डेटा. सेकंड डेटा मिळणं खूप सोपं असतं, दॅट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पब्लिश्ड वन. सो वी गेट, आजकाल तर खूपच सोपं झालं आहे, नेटवर सगळा डेटा उपलब्ध असतो. वी जस्ट download that particular report and all and we start analyzing the required things. So that was second data and it is very simple to collect it as compared to primary data. Primary data thodas collect karna avghad asta, pan ni matlya pramane anki ekda sange, mostly ja methods vaparto apan tya don pas vaparto. Apan interview conduct karto, otherwise apan questionnaire la jato. And in 90% 99% matlab tari chale, people go for questionnaire and they complete their research or they collect data through questionnaire. Questionnaire madhunus barach vela apan maiti gola karat asto and tes apan tithe vaparat asto. Tyanantar sarvat mahatvachi gosht that we are going to see today is data analysis and presentation. So how to collect the data? Whatever data we have collected, that will be analyzed by using some techniques. Data will be analyzed by using some techniques and that will be presented in a different form, in the form of tabulation, in the form of graphics, in the form of tables, and on the basis of that presentation we write inferences, we write इंटरप्रिटेशन्स आपण त्या टेबलच्या आधारे किंवा डेटा अनालिसिसच्या आधारे इन्फरन्स लिहित असतो, स्पष्टीकरण लिहितो, त्यानंतर इन्फरन्स आपण काय म्हणतो इंटरप्रिटेशन लिहित असतो आणि आपलं एक त्याच्यावरून आपण पुन्हा फाइंडिंग्स लिहितो, सजेशन्स लिहितो. So what is the purpose of data analysis? To answer the research question and to help the help to determine the trends and relationship among the variables. जे काय आपण variables ठरवले आहेत त्याच्यामधलं जर relationship सांगायचं असेल तर data analysis is the most important aspect. And basically we go for data analysis to find out the answer for our questions. Whatever research questions we have at the time of designing hypothesis, at the time of framing objectives, those questions will be answered by doing data analysis. So data analysis is the most and important aspect, and mostly referees they go for data analysis. They see your data analysis jyavas apla thesis bahir jato evaluation sathi tyavas me mhatla na they go for maximum they go for they think about two aspects or they go for two aspects methodology baktat ani tumhi kasa data analysis kele karan see introductory part to tumhi ikrun tikrun लिहून बघून किंवा वाचन करूनच लिहिणार आहात, दॅट इज थेरटिकल एस्पेक्ट. नोबडी इज गोइंग टू नोबडी इज इंटरेस्टेड इन दॅट, नॉट मच इंटरेस्टेड इन द दोज टॉपिक्स. इव्हन लिटरेचर रिव्ह्यू सुद्धा त्यांना माहितीच आहे आपण दुसऱ्याचाच रिव्ह्यू करतोय. इथं मात्र तुमचं स्वतःचं कष्ट लागतं, इथं मात्र तुमचं स्किल वापरावं लागतं. सी इफ आय कलेक्ट, सपोज वी कलेक्ट सेम डेटा, आपण दोघांनी एकच प्रकारचा डेटा कलेक्ट केलाय, बट वाय गोईंग फॉर अनालिसिस आय कॅन यूज डिफरंट टेक्निक्स दॅन यू. तर कुठल्या टेक्निक्स वापरलेत दॅट इज अप टू यू, कोणत्या टेक्निक वापरायच्या ते तुम्ही ठरवता, कारण तुम्हाला त्या विषयाची डेप्थ असते. माझे टेक्निक्स वेगळे असतील, तुमचे टेक्निक वेगळे असतील, रिझल्ट वेगळे असतील. सो एव्हरीबडी इज इंटरेस्टेड इन द डेटा अनालिसिस अँड दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट आस्पेक्ट ऑफ रिसर्च. हेच बघितलं जातं. तुमचं थेसिस जर समजा 400 पानाचं असेल तर आणि तुमचं डेटा अनालिसिस जर समजा 100 पानाचं असेल तर ते 100 पानच खूप महत्त्वाचे लक्षात ठेवा. सो हिअर there are some steps in data analysis. Data collections केल्यानंतर आपण आणि त्या अनालिसिस जातो. आफ्टर डेटा अनालिसिस आपल्याला काय मिळतं, वी प्रोसेस द डेटा, प्रिपेअर टेबल्स अँड ग्राफ्स, अनालाइज अँड इंटरप्रिट फाइंडिंग्स, कन्सल्ट अगेन द स्टॅटिस्टिशियन. आपण कधी कधी जर आपल्याला स्टॅटिस्टिक्स जमत नसेल तर वी गो अँड वी कन्सल्ट विथ द स्टॅटिस्टिशियन फॉर प्रॉपर अंडरस्टँडिंग ऑफ स्टॅटिस्टिकल टूल्स फॉर युअर रिसर्च. देन वी प्रिपेअर प्रेझेंटेशन्स, मीन्स वी राईट interpretations and you know what we call it inferences. Then kinds of data analysis, kiti prakare apan data analysis karto, don prakare karto, descriptive analysis and inferential analysis. When this descriptive analysis is important, that also I'm going to tell you, and this when inferential analysis is important, that also I will tell you. I'm not getting this Marathi word for this one, but those who are from education they will tell us the words which are useful, which can be used for descriptive and inferential. So descriptive means kai, we try to whatever data which we have collected, we try to write in a descriptive manner. And basically when we collect information through interview, see in questionnaires are common. We set one question and that questionnaire, and we circulate the same questionnaire to others also. So question and even answers that is in the form of tick are different, but those are also common. But here in case of interview, if I conduct the interview of 10 different people, answer will be different. Pratyekacha answer vegla asel. So while writing, while going for analysis on the basis of interview, I have to write my opinion after conducting 10 interview in a descriptive form. So that is what this descriptive analysis is must one. And we go for when we want to go for descriptive analysis, we want to, or we should go for descriptive statistics which are used in the descriptive analysis. What is that? We go for frequency distribution, and through that we can understand a systematic arrangement of numerical values from the lowest to highest and highest to lowest. Here we are going to find out how it is arranged and how it is systematically arranged in terms of numerical values, and for that we go for this frequency distribution. हे सगळं तुम्हाला आता नाही पण नंतर खूप उपयोगी आहे. नंतर तुम्हाला ह्याच्यासाठी जर जमत नसेल तर तुम्हाला कॉन्टॅक्टच करावं लागेल स्टॅटिस्टिशियनशी. देन मेजरमेंट ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडन्सी, जस्ट आय एम गिविंग अन आयडिया, तुम्हाला इंटरव्ह्यूला जर विचारलं तर उत्तर सांगता यावं म्हणून हे सगळं चाललंय. हा पार्ट तुम्ही घरी इंटरव्ह्यूच्या अगोदर अवश्य बघा, कारण ते टूल्स वगैरे विचारू शकतात तुम्हाला. तुम्हाला हे मी म्हटल्याप्रमाणे तुम्ही प्रपोजलमध्ये कोणतेही तुम्हाला जे वाटतं ते लिहिले तरी चालेल, मात्र वेन यू गो फॉर actual analysis of your research, then it is It is very much perfect. It is very much specific. No issue. Right. So then classification of descriptive analysis, that is measures of variability. So this also you see at home. So see, we measure variables in two different forms. We measure variables in the form of range. Range upon calculate karto, and we also go for standard deviation. We try to find out the standard deviation between two different variables, and we try to measure the variability or variability between those two variables. That is also, it can be used. For the lakshya, the classification of descriptive analysis, it can be done like this. Then kinds of data analysis, second one, that is inferential analysis. And here we go for writing inferences based on statistical tools and techniques and tests that we use. Apan je kai statistical tools and techniques we use for the purpose of analysis. And when we go for analysis or such types of analysis, it becomes inferential analysis, because your, you know, interpretation is based on some numerical results. And this is what we conduct, n number of tests which are applicable according to your sample, according to your data. कुठलीच टेस्ट तुम्ही वापरू शकत नाही. प्रत्येक टेस्ट वापरण्यासाठी तुम्हाला काय नियम आहेत, काय यु नो रूल्स आहेत, की टेस्ट टी टेस्ट कधी वापरायची, झेड टेस्ट कधी वापरायची, एफ टेस्ट कधी वापरायची. दॅट इज यु नो देर इज वन सर्टन सॉर्ट ऑफ रूल फॉर दॅट. अँड वेन यू गो फॉर ॲक्च्युअल अनालिसिस, देअर यू विल अंडरस्टँड वेन शुड वी गो फॉर टी एफ अँड झेड. सो लेवल्स ऑफ सिग्निफिकन्स, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू यु नो कम्पेअर, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू यु नो judge the parameters, so we go for level of significance, that is 0.01 or 0.05. You'll recall me at the time of analysis when you go for all those things. Then we go for tests. As I told you, test we go for, ANOVA we go for, chi-square we go for. So n number of tests are there, according to your requirement you can go for it. Now you can write your only names in the research proposal. You can write ANOVA, you can write chi-square, you can write t-test, you can write f-test, you can go for MANOVA, you can go for binomial, you can go for MANO also. So you can write names over there. They are not going to ask you each and every part in detail. They also know that you are the beginners, so they know your limitations. तुम्हाला ते काही एवढं कळत जाणार नाही. त्यांनाही माहिती आहे की तुम्ही आता सुरुवात करताय, फक्त तुम्हाला आयडिया आहे का. ऍक्च्युली तुम्हाला असं कदाचित विचारू शकतील की मीनिंग वगैरे सांगा, म्हणून हा थेरॉटिकल पार्ट दिलाय, किंवा नेमकं काय असतं याच्यामध्ये, व्हेरिएबल म्हणजे काय, डिपेंडेंट व्हेरिएबल म्हणजे काय, इंडिपेंडेंट व्हेरिएबलचे काय, असे प्रश्न येऊ शकतील. येणार येतीलच असं नाही, पण येऊ शकतील. त्यासाठीच हे थोडंसं तुम्हाला मी मटेरियल देतोय, नावं देतोय, तुम्हाला माहिती असले पाहिजे म्हणून. देन हा द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट पार्ट दॅट आय एम गोइंग टू शो यू. सो ओके, अनालिसिस, द टूल्स ऑफ अनालिसिस आर ओव्हर. नाव आय वॉन्ट टू गिव यू सम, आय वॉन्ट टू गिव टू डेमोज. How SPSS, this is IBM SPSS, actually IBM has taken this, actually it was not IBM's product in the past, but IBM has taken just now. And this one is a software, that is a statistical package for social sciences. This one is a full form of SPSS, and this can be used for research in social sciences. And this SPSS has made research simple. Whatever headache was there, that is removed by SPSS. But if you want to use SPSS in research, jar tumhala SPSS research madhe vaparayacha asel, so you should be comfortable, you should be, you know, smart in using SPSS. You should have some knowledge of using SPSS. And this is what this small two demos are, you know, I have kept for you guys, and that I'm going to show you. So I'm getting back to the I'm going to the next slide. So these two, three slides are added after, you know, I thought, why don't I show you a demo of using SPSS. So here we are going for t-test for single mean. There's only one variable we are considering, and that variable is what? Satisfaction level. And we are considering the satisfaction level of 12 employees. There are 12 employees, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, to 12. And satisfaction level we have decided here. And the level of significance is 0.1% that we have written here. So see, satisfaction level is measured in two different forms, that is satisfied, highly satisfied, neutral, then highly satisfied, dissatisfied, satisfied, this way, remember. So this one is the example. And if you want to go for t-test by using the single mean for one variable is there, remember, one variable. And what is that variable? Satisfaction level. And we have collected data from 12 people. So 12 people are here and they have given their responses. So this is ES, HS, A and HSD. These are the responses of those 12 people. Number one person said, yes, satisfied. Second one said, highly satisfied. Third one said, no, neutral. He is not going to say. He is not satisfied, even he is not highly satisfied. Or even he is not dissatisfied also. So neutral is neutral. So this way responses are written. And now we are going for analyzing the data. So this way it can be done. So I'm getting back to the, you know what, our home slide. I stopped my current presentation and I'll get back to the SPSS software. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. I'll show you how it can be done. It's very simple, but you should have some knowledge of, you know, IBM SPSS. I'm starting my presentation again. And here I'm going to show you how t-test can be done. So data is already, you know, inserted by me to save your time. We are directly going for analysis of that particular data. Just a minute. This is my second model, which is ready with me. So, okay, we are going for t-test. I request all of you to see it carefully because you're going to use in future for your studies. Just wait, it is taking sort of time. Having this SPSS version number 26. Now it is updated with 28. Version number 28 is the current version. But you can use any version as we are doing research.
Sir, is it free, open source? Is this software open source?
No. Sorry, but I have taken from my friend. But
okay.
If you want to buy this, it is costly. So see.
Okay.
How much it costs, sir?
Around more than 1 lakh. So whatever data we have, I have shown you, that is, you know, this data is taken here already, which is entered. Look at this. This one is a, you know, a mean, or that one is a variable, that is satisfaction level. So accordingly, we have to design. Actually, I wanted to show you all of this, but you know, that much time is not there. I will directly show you how the t-test can be performed. There are two views in SPSS, variable view and data view. When you want to enter the data, you go for variable data. You can write second variable here also. In this way, the variable leu shakta. And tyaprmane tumhi te scale vagere decide karu shakta. Once the variable view is over, it is complete, then you go for analysis. That is data view. So whatever data we have entered, that is there. So see, numbers are given. For example, satisfied, we have given number one. Highly satisfied, number two. Then neutral, number three. So these are the answers which we have written in the form of what? Numbers. Now we are going to perform t-test. So go to analyze. Only this much is the option which is useful for all of us as far as, you know, our analysis is concerned. Go to analyze. Then go to compare means. There is one option, compare means. And then go to one sample t-test. We are talking about only one sample, only one variable. Go for one sample t-test. This window will be there. Just take this sample for analysis. So if you do this, I think this one is already selected. You just click on this button. It will take for the analysis. Then go for the options. If you want certain things, you here you can decide the confidence level. You can change this confidence level, but mostly people keep 90%, and that is appropriate. Then you continue and directly click on OK. You get these kind of results. So this is your t-test. On the basis of this one sample test, you know, results generated here, you can use these tables directly for your research thesis. And on the basis of information, especially, you know, sign 0, this one is the, you know, level of significance. If it is 0.05, then your test is rejected. It is 0.0 here or 0.000 here. So whatever hypothesis you have made at the time of going for this test is approved. So this way you have to go. This one is a small example. It is very, you know, so many things are there to learn. So this way you can perform the test. Then I'll show you one more. That is
sir, if suppose I don't have this software with me, so how we can execute this day test in future whenever the right time comes for us?
See, if you want to go for your data analysis, then you have to take the help of statistician if you don't have. And even statisticians, other softwares are also available in the market, but this one is the most perfect one for social sciences. And if you want to prove that whatever data is collected, if you want to test your hypothesis, you have to take the help of statistics. और अगर हम statistics के language बोलते हैं तो वो बहुत लोगों को पसंद आता है और accept होता है.
Okay.
So this is what it is, must sir. Learn something. Otherwise, you take somebody's help. This one is the only option.
Sure. Thanks.
Then we will go for one more. That is ANOVA, one-way classification. So here, what we have taken, the following table gives the yields of 15 sample of plot under the variety of seeds. Varieties of seeds are there. There are three varieties of seeds. Varieties are mentioned here. So two hypotheses they have given. Null hypothesis, alternative. This one is negative. How it is negative? Look at this. There is no significance. And here we are talking about alternative means what? There is a significance. You'll understand everything. For example, I'm showing. तुम्हारा ही नंतर पुढे जाऊँ सगळं करणार आहे. Showing एक information माहिती असली पाहिजे म्हणून तुम्हाला दाखवते. Now we are going to talk about this ANOVA, how it can be done. Okay. Okay. One way ANOVA. Please cooperate. It is going to open. Okay. Here also, if whatever template you open or whatever file you open, there are two views always. That is, you know, a variable view and data view. If you want to enter your data which is collected, then you guys have to go for variable view. Write your variable, then decide the type, decide the width, decimal, labels and all. Then you go for deciding the measurement scale. That is, there are three types of scale. If I click here, you may understand. Scale, ordinal, nominal, there are two scales, three scales by the way. So how those scales can be used, that is a different part, but just I'm showing an example. Now this data is ready with us. Now we are going for analysis and we are going for one-way ANOVA. Again, you guys have to go for, this one is a result of your data entered in the form of variable. Go for analysis. They then go for non-parametric test. ANOVA comes under this. Then you go for one sample. Sorry, you go for legacy dialogue. And there is one thing, that is one sample KS, that is ANOVA. If you click on this, this window will open. Then you take this one here. Then write some options if you want some descriptive. If you want, then you only go for. Otherwise, they're not necessary to click on descriptive. Then if you want normal, there are options, uniform and all. You just click on normal, you get normal results. These are the results. This is non-parametric test and we get result in this particular form. Again, you have to write your inferences on the basis of this value 0.94, and you have to make it confirm whether your hypothesis is accepted or not. So this is for one-way ANOVA. We can go for, by using this data, we can go for chi-square and all. Just look at this. Yes, yes. रिजेक्ट झाला 0.0.5 पेक्षा कमी असला पाहिजे तर ऍक्सेप्टेड. सी हियर व्हॉट इज अवर यू नो लेट मी शो यू वेअर इज दॅट. लेट मी शो यू, प्लीज वेट. सी वेअर इज दॅट, वेअर इज माय पीपीटी, जस्ट वेट. We have decided level of significance. See, we have decided level of significance, and what we have written here, just let me show you. See, level of significance is 0.05, and you know, always which is considered null hypothesis, there is no significant difference between the average yield of three varieties of fruits. If the result is, or the you know, level of significance is below than 0.05, then null hypothesis is accepted. Remember, if the level of significance is below than 0.05, then null hypothesis is accepted. If it is more than 0.05, then alternative hypothesis is accepted, but null hypothesis is rejected. Getting my point? Jar 0.05 pekshya kami asel tar tumcha hypothesis null hypothesis accept hoto, ani nasel tar reject hoto. Evde lakshat theva. नाही, आपण लेवल ऑफ सिग्निफिकन्स बदलत राहतो. अकॉर्डिंग टू द टेस्ट वी कीप चेंजिंग दॅट. ओके सर, ओके. ऍक्च्युली हे खूप डीप मध्ये आहे, पण एक तुम्हाला थोडस त्याची जाणीव असावी म्हणून हे मी दाखवले. देन वी कॅन ऑल्सो गो फॉर अनदर पॅरामेट्रिक टेस्ट, दॅट इज यु नो ट्रू सॅम्पल्स. Nice. Two sample is not possible. We are considering only one sample here, that is variety of seeds. So this way we can go for it. So these are the some sort of, you know, demos to understand the concept of SPSS and how it can be used in SPSS. So I'm getting back to my you know, home screen to answer your queries. So here we have done with the methods of data collection and analysis, tools of analysis. So any question? Let me check, let me take your overall questions first, and after that I'll go for questions in chat box. Any question for today's session? Today we have tried our level best to cover each and every part which is required in the research. खरं तर आजचा पार्ट एवढा तुम्हाला रिसर्च प्रपोजल साठी एवढा महत्त्वाचा नव्हता, पण भावी काळामध्ये तुम्हाला सुद्धा माहिती असलं पाहिजे आणि तुम्हाला असं नाही वाटलं पाहिजे की सरांनी काय पार्ट सोडलाय. खरं तर एवढ्या वर्ष मागच्या कालच्या दिवसापर्यंत चाललं असतं, पण म्हटलं नाही थोडंसं ॲडिशनल देऊयात आणि वेगळ्या पद्धतीने देऊयात. आणि आय ट्राईड माय लेवल बेस्ट टू गिव यू ऑर टू मेक यू अवेअर अबाउट ईच अँड एव्हरी ॲस्पेक्ट ऑफ रिसर्च. स्टील रिसर्च इज नॉट यु नो दॅट मच नॅरो कॉन्सेप्ट टू कवर इन 6 days, बट आय ट्राईड माय लेवल बेस्ट टू कवर इट इन 6 days. इफ आय डीड समथिंग रॉंग, एक्स्ट्रीमली सॉरी फॉर दॅट. इफ आय मिस्ड समथिंग, प्लीज टेल मी. आय विल ट्राय टू प्रोव्हाइड सम मटेरियल, आय ट्राय टू प्रोव्हाइड युअर क्लिअर युअर डाऊट्स अँड ऑल. So thank you very much for trusting me and joining this workshop. Now I'm taking your questions, and after that I will, at the end I will also say something. Okay.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Okay.
In format of a research proposal, you have given the 18th question, sorry, 19, 20 and 21st, knowledge contribution and likely correct outcomes.
Correct.
Chapter scheme and selected bibliography. That I correct got it. But okay, chapter scheme that you want in this your index, the acknowledgement, chapter 1 is for this, chapter 2 is this, in that
correct
way,
correct,
something
correct
different it is.
No, in a tentative manner, but
okay,
but in a tentative manner, but as good as final. Remember,
yes,
like first topic number or chapter number is introduction, chapter
yeah
number 2 research literature review,
research
chapter
review
number 3 chapter number 3 that is, you know, research methodology.
Yes,
chapter
sir.
Number 4 profile of the organizations, for example, if you are selecting some organizations. In chapter
okay.
number 5 analysis of data and interpretation. Chapter number 6 finding, suggestion and conclusion. That's all.
Yeah.
In this way.
Okay.
But all those are tentative. Those are not final.
Yes. Just as a we can say that.
Yes.
Before
as
the
a part and, yes, for the part of, as a part of part and parcel of your proposal. Yes.
Yes, miss. At least we know the what chapters we are going to include.
Yes. Cover.
Now proposal
we are going to write.
Final also. That
correct.
Idea
correct.
We are going to.
Correct.
And one
correct.
More question I had that sir, knowledge yeah. contribution and likely outcomes. That I'm not getting because three of them,
yes, yes.
17, 18 and 19, I have left it out when I submit
okay.
your my proposal
okay.
format to you.
I will tell you, don't worry. When it
yes.
comes to knowledge contribution and likely outcomes, see, you're doing research, no doubt, and it is expected you are going to contribute something in the knowledge, or you're going
yes.
to give some in the form of content which will be useful for, you know, next generation.
Yes, sir.
So how you are going or how your research is going to contribute something in the knowledge or existing knowledge. See,
okay.
you are doing something new and how it is going to contribute in the form of knowledge in the existing knowledge that you have to write there. Then see. Hello. Hello.
Sanjay, your audio is having a problem. It gives a static. So when you put on the mic, so can you change your mic while the question is answered?
Okay. Madam. Then it comes to likely outcomes. So what you expect, what sort of outcomes you are expecting from your research that you have to write there. Okay.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Okay, yes.
So
next.
The format which I have sent, whatever is knowledgeable to me, in
yeah.
that format I have given you, you're free to find out the errors or what is your suggestion regarding,
yes, madam.
You can mention it. So I'll make my... provisional time to change what you have done it.
Okay, madam. I'll go through your all your
sir.
Means proposals. Just let me complete.
Yes.
I'll go through your proposals in a, you know, very deep manner. I'll go through it precisely and I'll
yes.
get back to you very soon. And I'm
yes,
going
sir.
To see everybody's proposal. Okay, don't worry.
Sir, take your time. I don't
yes,
say
yes.
that way. Take your own time and you can do it because six
yes,
days
ma'am.
You're also busy with this lectures.
No, not that much. But next week I am having one workshop in college. And
okay.
I will be busy with that workshop, but I will, you know, find some time to go through your proposal a lot.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, sure. Yes.
So one question related to this respondent.
Yes, correct.
Sir, I am going to use this historical data for this research purpose. So it's not going to be like an collecting a data from. People or maybe like an interview. So how we put that as like, so this data would be more of like, let's say the alloy, ferroalloy prices for the period of like maybe a 2019 to 2021.
So you're using secondary data, no? You're using
secondary data. Yeah.
So
and those data collection would be from the available website, market intelligence website. That I have an access to that. So
okay.
How
so you're
yeah, write the
okay.
as a respondent there as in class.
So in addition to this, I am having one more question. And if I get answer from you, definitely I will tell you. So your entire study is based on your secondary data?
Yes, entire study is based on secondary data only. No
but for and there you are collecting future past references, right?
Yeah, the past references, finding the correlation between those variables and then developing further a model for forecasting the prices.
Okay, so in this case, you have to go for two types of analysis.
Okay.
Whatever analysis you are making on the basis of that second data, for that you go for descriptive analysis. And if you are going for making variables and testing those variables through statistical tools, then you go for inferential analysis also. So this way you have to go for analysis.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I wrote as a tool of like a correlation analysis and regression analysis.
It means you are going to use some statistical data also, right?
Yeah, most of them. It's, I think more than 90%.
And you are going to find your inferences on the basis of some references also.
Yes, references.
For, writing the inferences of references, you go for descriptive analysis.
Okay.
And for another one, you go for statistical. That is, you know, what we call it, inference analysis.
Okay.
Based on statistical data and statistical tools, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir. Vasuraj, sir, boliye. Yeah.
I have one question. As we complete this workshop, when will we get the e-certificate?
Do you want certificate or what?
I'm talking about you are saying now in workshop.
Yes, yes. They actually, definitely I'm going to issue the certificates and all, but it will take at least 4-5-6 days to get it done. But I will issue you, don't worry.
Sir, I have one sir? Also. Hello, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, please.
I have one clarification. Just I want to know the details about means I not I thoroughly get knowledge about all the topics, but I don't.
Hello. I think Basura sir is disconnected. Is not in the meeting. Yes, sir. Please repeat.
Hello. I want to know the detail about the topic of hypothesis.
Okay, you just go through the recordings, you'll be able to understand. If not, call me, I will tell you in detail. No issue.
Okay. Thank you.
Sir, I have some questions regarding the marketing of ourselves. It will be a little bit different. Like, for example, now there would be like, for example, we have the 15 seats in the management of Pumba.
Okay.
And there would be against me, there would be competing some of the students, some of the assistant professor who wanted to do the PhD, myself as a working professional, and everybody, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I just wanted to ask you one question, which is based on like research question itself.
Okay.
Then what is the preference given to assistant professor as compared to other people? Working professionals and all, or it is depending on that particular your qualifications as well as the research committee proposals and your interview.
See, sir, when it comes to selection or final selection, as you are expecting, there is no such sort of parameters to select for the PhD. Means they are not going to select from the assistant professor. They are not going to select from working professional or like that. Your performance at the time of interview and your research proposal does matter. It is the only matter. How you are going to answer their questions, if you are going to satisfy them with your answers, and if your proposal impresses them, definitely they will select you. Remember one thing, there is no biased views about working professional or they gonna select only assistant professor. It is not like that. It is up to your performance, how you present yourself in front of the or before the committee, even what sort of proposal you are carrying. They definitely ask some questions on your proposal. And if you satisfy with your answers to those questions, definitely they will select you. So this is, in Marathi we call it kaya dagda urchi reshe. Jar tumhi ya don goshti perfect gela tar. I request you all, remove these thoughts from your mind. They are going to select from assistant professor. There is something sort of different practices. No, I have only taken this experience at the time of getting selected for my PhD. Even I also worked as a member of interview panel. From last 2-3 years, I'm doing this. So there, I know the practices. So it is not like that. There is no need to go for such kind of practices. Just trust on yourself and go accordingly.
Sir, quick question.
Please go ahead.
Yeah, how much time is allocated for one individual for this interview?
Minimum 15 to 15 minutes they take. Minimum 15 minutes you consider. 15 minutes to milenge. So anyhow, there will be 15 minutes. Because
How many interviewers will be there? The panel size?
Minimum four. Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
So, sir, there is some semantic type of experience of mine after attending the workshop. सो प्रीवियसली लाइक आई वॉज थिंकिंग कि मैं निकल जाऊंगा, थोड़ा ओवर कॉन्फिडेंस था. बट आफ्टर अटेंडिंग द वर्कशॉप, यू नो, आफ्टर सीइंग सो मच ऑफ नॉलेज एंड ऑल, यू नो, इट्स टू वेज दैट आई नो वेयर टू प्रिपेयर एंड इट्स लिटिल बिट मींस थोड़ा कॉन्फिडेंस तो लूज हो रहा है कि इतना सब होगा तो मैं कैसे कर पाऊंगा. सो माय रिक्वेस्ट इज काइंडली बी विद अस बिकॉज मच मोर हैंड होल्डिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड.
Correct.
And more you get the knowledge, more you find inadequacies in you. That is one of the factor which is working with me at present. So
okay.
I am really, really thank you very much from my bottom of my heart that you have gone through so much of details and you have taken 6 days continuous efforts. But that is what the situation is at the end of the 6 days.
Correct. Okay. So in addition to this, I must say, Sanjay sir, and to everyone, as I told you at the beginning of my session, this is not an association of 6 days. Remember, I'm always there with you guys. This group will remain forever. I request you all not to leave from the group. We will be there. And if you want to ask some questions, please put your questions in our group. I will definitely answer. Try to, you know, whenever you get some problem and if you want to talk with me, text me personally or call me. If I do not attend your call, there is no need to bother. I'll get back to you. It means, you know, main agar kuch kaam mein ho, agar phone nahi attend kar raha hu, so there is no need to worry. Just I'll get back to you whenever I get free from my work. So this association is not for, remember, this association is not for 6 days. At least this association is there till your PhD degree. This I expect. I'm very, you know, very, what do we call it? Khub mera manus hai, tum jab aur nahi aase. And I'll be there always with you all. There is no question.
Hello.
It is for 6 months. Yes,
Hello.
Madam. Yes, madam.
हाँ सर, तुम्ही परवा दिवशी ते संशोधन प्रस्तावाचे जे स्वरूप दिले होते ना, त्यानुसार सिनॉप्सिस तयार करायचे का, जे 21 पॉइंट दिले होते ते?
सिनॉप्सिस नाही, प्रपोजल मॅडम. मी अजून एकदा रेक्टिफाय करतोय, वी आर नॉट मेकिंग सिनॉप्सिस, वी आर मेकिंग प्रपोजल.
ओके,
प्रपोजल बनवायचे. सिनॉप्सिस तुमचा पीएचडी सबमिट व्हायच्या 2 महिने अगोदर असतो, आता नाही.
अच्छा, मग इंटरव्ह्यूला तेच फेस कराय, तेच प्रेझेंट करायचं असतं का?
प्रेझेंट करायचंच नसतं, फक्त सोबत घेऊन जायचं असतं. ते तुम्हाला त्याच्या साधारणपणे 3-4 कॉपीज घेऊन जा. तिथे काय 3-4 लोक जे असतील ना, त्या 3-4 लोकांना द्या अँड दे गो थ्रू युअर रिसर्च प्रपोजल 1 by 1 अँड दे आर सम क्वेश्चन्स बेस्ड ऑन युअर रिसर्च प्रपोजल. ओके
ओके ओके, थँक्यू,
वेलकम मॅडम. अँड सी, आय वॉन्ट टू टेल यू वन मोर थिंग, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू से समथिंग, टेक्स्ट मी पर्सनली, आय विल अन्सर इच अँड एव्हरी क्वेश्चन, डझंट मॅटर. अँड वॉट एव्हर सॉर्ट ऑफ हेल्प यू वॉन्ट फ्रॉम माय एंड, from my side, I'm always there, don't worry. But please speak me frankly. Kutlehi, do not keep any barrier in our communication. Whatever you want to feel, whatever you want to talk, and if you do not want to talk in the group, just text me personally. I'll go for your answer. I'll go for your query anytime. And there is no restriction of calling at all. Remember, you can call me anytime. But if I do not attend, it means I'm busy with some work and I'll get back to you. Whenever I get free. Yes.
Sir, just to say that when we had a first telephonic talk with you, that
yes,
time
ma'am.
You say that, ma'am, you please join. Definitely,
yes.
You'll be satisfied.
Correct,
that
madam.
Even you have said that time also as a by profession as a teacher, so many doubts and so many things here. But now I'll clear that all my doubts and all my things are 100% it has clear. So I gained the confidence about that. So it's a big thank you to you for getting such a way and create an interest towards a research. Really, thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, madam, for your, you know, compliment. Definitely, this compliment
yes.
will
really,
be...
Really, sir, from bottom of my heart, I'm telling, I'm really happy with what the session you had been taken.
Thank you very, very much, madam. This compliment will, you know, boost me to conduct more research workshops.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes,
thank
ma'am.
You, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, madam.
Hello.
Yes,
sir.
Yes,
I have a question. Like,
yeah.
You know, for one position, on an average, you know, how many people they call for an interview for one position? Any tentative number?
See, this is not a ratio as such. This kind of ratio is not there. Basically, what happens, for example, you know, there is one research center, for example, and if your subject is business administration, for example, we are considering, and for in that research center, there are four research guides, and they are having four sets with each guide. So there are 16 sets, for example. So ratio as such is not there. People apply to research centers. See, when you apply for research center, you see the vacant seats of guides at that particular research centers. So those who have applied there in that research centers, those will be called for the interview. Suppose I have applied for University of Pune DCRC Department of Commerce. So those who have applied for DCRC, they will be called for the interview. And there are n number of research centers in University of Pune for commerce and management. And according to the applications received for their research centers, they call for the interview according to the subjects also. So ratio as such is not there, proportion as such is not there. So whoever have applied for the that particular research centers, those people are called, those people will be called for the interview. This is the funda.
But that selection depends on the number of guides available. Like if four guides are available, so six, like
it depends upon the number of guides and number of vacant seats available with the guide according to the categories also.
Okay.
Yeah.
So one more thing which is coming from me.
Yes, sir. So this is always.
Yeah, so my research proposal is already with you, and I think you commented that this is very interesting type of...
Correct.
This is of national interest, and what we are talking about, you know, incapacitations of all the pandemic activity, what we've done during the COVID and the effect of that in the future, you know, circumstances.
Correct. Actually, when I gone through your title, I understood that this one is an interesting one. But sir, give me some time, I'll go through the entire proposal.
Okay.
And definitely I will have some comments. I will come up with some sort of, you know, suggestions also. No issue.
Yeah.
But give me 2-3 days more. I'll go.
Yeah, through. I'll definitely, sir. And one more thing, that I'm writing the research, one research paper, which is completely devoted for the marketing. Like for example, marketing 4.0, and then what we're talking about green production, green revolutions. We are talking about, you know, blue ocean strategies. So what I'll do is I will share that paper with you. Though it is a very confidential, but I'll share with you. And please suggest me that as for your your observation, being a research committee member, would you prefer? And then accordingly, then I'll start making up the list.
Yes, definitely, sir. I'll go through your research paper also, and I'll get back to you, sir, very soon.
Thank you.
Welcome, sir. Any more question? Otherwise, I'll go for chat box and I'll see whether the questions are there or not. If it is not there, then I'll go for chat box. In chat box, let me see if there any question or not. I think there is no question. Everybody is thanking me. I welcome you all. And so should we stop here?
Maybe last question, sir.
Okay, sir. I'm ready with n number of questions, and I'm very eager to answer your questions. I'm expecting so many questions today, as today is the last day.
Just one request, that if you can give a feedback for that proposal, research proposal, with your maybe by writing for those points in red color, so that will really help.
It is in my mind. Definitely, I'm going to do the same things. But sir, this is my request to you all. As I'm busy with some activities till Wednesday, but after that I'll go through your proposal. I'll start going through your proposal. So please give me a few time for this. But till next Sunday, I'll come up with some suggestions and all, and some comments on your proposal. Means all of your proposal. No issue.
Oh, great, sir. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. Sure.
Sir, I have one question.
Yes, sir.
Sir, is there is any useful Android app in market for means pursuing a PhD or research, doing research or getting
career
knowledge?
App for what?
Means regarding helpful for research or doing PhD.
See, sir, if you go for any sort of app, it will be a little bit technical and mechanical. And in research, this kind of mechanical things are not useful, because you know your topic, you know the limitations of your topic in general. if you perform your research by your own, then you will enjoy that. And if you're taking the help of some sort of app and all, you will not enjoy, and things will be mechanical. And as far as my knowledge is concerned, there are no app as such to conduct the research in social sciences.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome, sir. Any more question from my dear participants? I think there is no question.
Sir, one second.
Okay. Yes, sir.
फॉर द आर आर सी म्हणजे एकदा आर आर सी जर झाली असेल म्हणजे त्याच्यात जर आपला टॉपिक रिजेक्ट झाला सो सेकंड टाइम म्हणजे आपण किती वेळेस रिजेक्ट होऊ शकतो सर त्या टॉपिक साठी
सी लिसन टॉपिक रिजेक्शन मीन्स दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू डिनाय युअर टॉपिक दे विल गिव सम सजेशन रिजेक्शन मीन्स नॉट दे आर नॉट गोइंग एक्सेप्टिंग युअर टॉपिक दे विल एक्सेप्ट सम टॉपिक ऑन सर्टन कंडिशन दे विल पुट सम कंडिशन एंड दे विल आस्क यू टू मेक नेसेसरी चेंजेस Sometimes they may ask you to change objective, sometimes they may ask you to change hypothesis, sometimes they may ask you to change the title. So accordingly changes we need to make, and accordingly once again we have to resubmit it. Okay.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
This is the procedure. There is no, I mean, once the topic is submitted to the RR, they can give some suggestions. They can ask you to make some modifications. Okay.
Okay,
and they
sir.
Ask you to do in a given time. And nobody's topic is rejected totally like that. So remove this thought. And a PhD is means what? 100% result. Once you, you know, get your admission, it is going to complete anyhow, or you are going to pass in that. So that is expected. So there is no exam as such. Just you have to sit. Table work is there. You have to complete some formalities. You have to go for analysis and all. This way, anyhow, you are going to get it. Some people will complete in 3 years. Some people will complete in 5 years or like that. This is the only difference. Of duration. Otherwise, everyone is going to get it if it is approved by the RR committee. That is the only thing. Okay.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
सगळ्यांना मिळणार आहे PhD. कुणाला 5 मध्ये मिळेल, कुणाला 3 मध्ये मिळेल. फक्त मिळणार आहे. तुम्ही जशाप्रमाणे काम करताय, काही लोक fully devote their time for research work. काही लोक पार्ट टाइम करतील. काही लोकांना 3 वर्ष लागेल, काही लोकांना 5 वर्ष लागेल. पण एकदा सिलेक्शन झालं की तुमचं PhD होणार आहे. You will be a doctor very soon. But the duration of getting this doctorate degree, that is up to you. 3 वर्षात घ्यायची का 5 वर्षात घ्यायची का 7 वर्षात घ्यायची का 7 वर्ष मॅक्सिमम पिरियड असतो लक्षात ठेवा 7 वर्षानंतर तुमचं रजिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपायर होतं खरं तर 5 वर्ष असतो 5 वर्षानंतर तुम्हाला रिरजिस्ट्रेशन करावं लागतं जर पुढे नाही कम्प्लीट झाला तर आणि 7 वर्ष जर कम्प्लीट नाही झाला तर अगेन यू हॅव टू गो फॉर पेटंट ऑल दॅट इज द ओनली यु नो ड्रॉबॅक त्याच्यामुळे यू डिसाइड टार्गेट ऑफ 3 इयर्स ओनली नॉट 5 इयर्स ऑल्सो 3 वर्षात कम्प्लीट झालीच पाहिजे लक्षात ठेवा साधारणपणे 32-34 महिने तुमचं सगळं काम कम्प्लीट झालं पाहिजे 34-35 महिने तुम्ही प्री वायवा घ्या प्री वायवा झाला की 2 महिन्यात तुम्ही सबमिट करू शकता अँड आफ्टर दॅट यू कॅन सबमिट आफ्टर 2 मंथ्स यू विल बी एबल ऑर यू कॅन सबमिट युअर फायनल थेसिस साधारणपणे 2-3 महिन्यानं फायनल थेसिस सबमिट झाला की 2-3 महिन्यामध्ये ऑर आफ्टर 2 or 3 मंथ्स यू विल गेट युअर फायनल कॉल फॉर फायनल वायवा फ्रॉम युनिव्हर्सिटी आफ्टर गेटिंग 2 रिपोर्ट्स इफ युअर 2 रिपोर्ट्स आर पॉझिटिव्ह फ्रॉम द रेफरी देन दे विल कॉल युअर वायवा आउट ऑफ 3 रिमेंबर 3 पैकी 2 रिजल्ट तुमचे रिपोर्ट जर पॉझिटिव्ह आले तर तुम्हाला डायरेक्ट वायवाला बोलवलं जातं अँड इन दॅट वायवा ओनली दे डिक्लेअर दॅट नाव यू कॅन स्टार्ट कॉलिंग युअर सेल्फ डॉक्टर ओके
हॅलो सर
येस येस वसुराज
द पीएचडी प्रोसेस इज लाईक जस्ट अकॅडमिक इयर इन अकॅडमिक इयर वी सबमिट द मीन्स project in final time of academic year like that
sorry Basuraj but I didn't understand your question can you repeat the same
the project process is like in academic year we can submit the project in final step of academic year no the project
yes,
is
yes.
like that
see for PhD according to the standard duration that is 3 years but in between every 6 months you have to give your progress report in that progress report you guys have to tell what you have done in this first 6 months then second 6 months so after every 6 months there is a progress report presentation and at the end of 3 years you should think about your final submission and all so there is a you know control of university or control of your research center on your research whether you are doing your research or not and in the form of what progress report they call everyone or every researcher to tell their progress after 6 months and that is called what 6 monthly progress report presentation
okay thank you
okay ma'am
सर पॉसिबल टू क्लोज दिस रिसर्च बिफोर 3 years आल्सो और यू हैव टू टेक दैट
मच नो एक्चुअली इट वाज पॉसिबल बिफोर 2010 और बिफोर 2014 बट सडनली यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ पुणे हैज गिवन न्यू गाइडलाइंस सॉरी यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ पुणे इज नॉट देयर यूजीसी हैज गिवन न्यू गाइडलाइंस एंड दे हैव क्लियरली स्टेटेड दैट नो वन कैन सबमिट नो वन कैन कंप्लीट रिसर्च बिफोर 36 मंथ्स यू कैन सबमिट योर थीसिस आफ्टर 36 मंथ्स ओनली इट मींस 3 years are compulsory. After 36 okay. months or after completing 36 months, on next day you can submit your thesis, but not before 36 months. That is the restriction. It was not there previously, but they have started or they have put this restriction few years back only. I think 2 years or 1 year back. Actually, it was not there in my time. I submitted okay. my thesis in I think it was month number 28. 28 महिन्यामध्ये मी complete केलं.
Oh, great.
And yeah. Southeast Germany was an award. Before 3 years, I got my PhD. Yeah.
So now we have to wait till this 36 months. Yeah.
Correct. Anyhow, you have to work for 3 years. Okay, any more questions, Jaydeep sir? Jaydeep sir is the first person who registered for my workshop. So Jaydeep sir started.
Great. Thank you. Correct. Thank you, sir.
Okay, so I remember you, sir. And so I think questions are not there. Once again, let me check chat box. Any idea when the interview process will start? As I told you yesterday only, interview process will start at the end of the October or the first week of November. That is expected. And this is my personal prediction. And I hope so. It will be like this. Is that okay? Very big. Okay. It was interesting. Okay, with this, sir. Thank you for your compliment. Okay, I think questions are over. Even you guys are also not asking questions. So this is my request to you all. Tomorrow I'm sending the recordings. If not, I will send it by refer tomorrow. Then tomorrow definitely I'm sending feedback form. You guys have to give your feedback in that particular Google form and be honest. While getting your feedback will definitely boost me, and it will also, useful for me to make necessary improvements and improvisation in my, deliberations. So please give your honest feedback so that I can improve myself a lot. And if I improve myself, definitely you can see a different Dr. Janardhan Pawar in next workshop. So I hope you will give your honest feedback. Yeah, sir.
Sir, in fact, we required some feedback from your side also, that our presentations and punctuality and what are the things you required as a teacher that we need to have something very immediate.
Correct. See, as far as your feedback is concerned, means participants' feedback is concerned, I must say that all the participants are very much eager to do some new things. Some people they joined I found that they were not good in punctuality as far as punctuality part is concerned, but because of their family and work responsibilities, because of they were not good in punctuality, but all are very active. There are few, they asked so many questions, and I was expecting, but most of the people, they didn't ask questions. There are a number of reasons behind not asking questions. See, question बऱ्याच लोकांना असं असतं की प्रश्न तरी विचारत असतो, पण असं वाटत असतं की आपण विचारल्यामुळे आपला प्रश्न चुकतो का, आपल्याला म्हणजे लोक उगीच हसतील का, असं काही नसतं. क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन मनात काही येऊ शकतो, तर तो विचारला गेला पाहिजे. दिस इज माय पर्सनल ओपिनियन. पण एक गोष्ट मात्र आहे की तुम्ही लोकांनी खरंच खूप चांगला इंटरेस्ट, खरंच आपण म्हणतो ना की द सक्सेस ऑफ द वर्कशॉप इज नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन द रिसर्च पर्सन, इट इज डिपेंड अपॉन द पार्टिसिपेंट ऑल्सो. I am very thankful, I am very fortunate that I have this kind of participants, and because of this kind of participation and participants' performance, I could do it in a very good way. Tumcha participation mulke tumcha sarke lokal mulas khar tar mi changlya paddhatine ghu shaklo, and day one person mala evada changla response mala ki mi that day only I decided that ki now I am giving 100% to my participants, and I want to make them happy anyhow, and that was my thought. आणि त्या पद्धतीने मी करण्याचा प्रयत्न केला. मी म्हणणार नाही की मी 100% तुम्हाला लोकांना सॅटिस्फाय केलं, आय हॅव सॅटिस्फाईड यू 100%, बट आय ट्राईड माय लेवल बेस्ट टू मेक यू सॅटिस्फाईड. सो दिस इज माय अँड एज फार एज युअर फीडबॅक ऑन प्रपोजल इज कन्सर्न, दॅट इज आय एम कमिंग पर्सनली. वन बाय वन. त्याच्यावर तुम्ही फीडबॅक लिहिणारच आहे, कमेंट्स मी लिहिणारच आहे. बट इफ स्टील यू वॉन्ट टू से समथिंग, टेक्स्ट मी पर्सनली. I'll be there to answer. I'll be there to solve every difficulty, every problem, and everything that you want to get it from me. So this is my humble request again. And as I once again I repeat this, our association is not for a 6 week. It will be there for forever, at least till your PhD degree. This I expect. Okay. And whenever
फक्त आपला जो ग्रुप आहे सर हा म्हणजे कंटिन्यू ठेवा, त्याच्यावर काही अपडेट्स असतील सर डेफिनेटली आम्हाला त्या अपडेट्स तुमच्याकडून देत
राहा. मी तर ग्रुप ठेवणारच आहे, पण माझी तुम्हाला विनंती आहे की तुम्ही कुणीही इथून लेफ्ट होऊ नका, हा ग्रुप असंच राहू. याच्यानंतर सुद्धा मी काय ज्या ऍक्टिव्हिटी करेन त्याचे मी तुम्हाला ब्रॉशर्स किंवा टाकत राहीन. तुम्हाला जर लागून असेल तर इतरांना पाठवा, बट वी विल बी इन कीप इन टच एनी हाउ. आणि वन मोर थिंग, कुठेही गरज लागली तर कधीही कॉल करा, कधीही बोला, काय अडचण नाही. ओके
सर, यू आर व्हेरी गुड टीचर अँड यू आर व्हेरी व्हेरी गुड ह्युमन बीइंग. थँक्यू व्हेरी मच.
थँक्यू सो मच. ओके, सो विथ दिस नोट आय एम गोइंग टू एंड माय सेशन. अँड एज आय टोल्ड यू, टुमॉरो आय एम सेंडिंग वन फीडबॅक लिंक. प्लीज फिल युअर ऑनेस्ट फीडबॅक अँड दॅट आय एम एक्सपेक्टिंग. अगर तुम्हाला काही आवड नसेल तर तेही आवर्जून सांगा, सो दॅट आय कॅन इम्प्रूव्ह माय सेल्फ. बरोबर सातव सर.
सर मला पण बोलावं असं वाटतंय. तुमचा उत्साह आमच्यासारख्या धडपडणाऱ्या होतकरू PhD विद्यार्थ्यांसाठी खूपच महत्वाचा होता, कारण की या PhD प्रोसेस मध्ये खूप प्रश्न आणि खूप शंका उपस्थित होतात, आणि जे वाचनातनं कि सॉल्व होत नाही, तर तुम्ही फार उत्साहाने प्रत्येक वेळी अगदी अगदी आदर्श शिक्षकासारखं प्रत्येक वेळेस आम्हाला गाईड केलं, त्याबद्दल तुमचे मनपूर्वक अभिनंदन. खूप चांगला शिक्षक आम्हाला बघायला मिळाला. तुमचं एक काय शिक्षक म्हणून जे एक होती बॉडी लँग्वेज होती, तुमचे सॉफ्ट स्किल्स आहे, द वे यू टीच, एव्हरीथिंग वॉज वर्थ लर्निंग फॉर वी टीचर्स ऑल्सो. सो थँक्यू सो मच सर फॉर युअर होल हार्टेड एफर्ट्स अँड कन्सर्न. थँक्यू सो मच सर.
थँक्यू मॅडम अँड थँक्यू व्हेरी मच फॉर युअर बेस्ट कॉम्प्लिमेंट. This definitely will help me to improve myself in this.
We will be definitely there in the group and we'll take your guidance, sir.
Yes, this is my humble request. Be there in the group.
Yes.
आणि सर दिवसभर काम करून प्लस बारामतीवरनं परत पुण्याला ट्रॅव्हल करून येऊन लगेच इमिजिएट 7:30 लेक्चर घेतलं, आणि तेवढ्या उत्साहाने तुम्ही आम्हाला खूप चांगलं मार्गदर्शन केलं. डेफिनेटली आम्हाला चांगला फायदा होईल आणि असंच आम्हाला सपोर्ट करत राहा. धन्यवाद सर.
नक्की माझा सपोर्ट तुमच्याशी असेल, जिथे जिथे माझी गरज आहे तुम्ही नक्की असेल सर. इवन वेन यू स्टार्ट युअर PhD वर्क, दोज डेज ऑल्सो यू जस्ट कॉल मी, आय विल बी देअर. अनालिसिस पार्ट असेल, कुठलाही पार्ट असेल, मला कॉन्टॅक्ट करा, मी तुम्हाला सोल्युशन सजेशन देत राहीन. SPSS मला खूप चांगलं जमतं तुमच्या माहितीच, तो इथं जरी तुम्हाला काय आडलं तर मला सांगा, आय विल हेल्प यू आउट इन दॅट केस ऑल्सो.
हॅलो सर.
येस सर, बसवराज.
हां सर, आय एम इम्प्रेस्ड विथ युअर एज्युकेशन क्वालिफिकेशन अँड ऑल्सो युअर एक्सप्लेनेशन अबाउट द PhD रिसर्च. थँक्यू व्हेरी मच.
ओके सर, ऍक्च्युली आय यु नो फक्त अभ्यासच करत राहिलो मी, ऍक्च्युली दॅट वॉज अ नीड ऑफ NR, आणि त्याच्यामुळं थोडंसं हे शक्य झालं आणि होत गेलं. तरी एक क्वालिफिकेशन मी त्याच्यामध्ये लिहिली नव्हती. आय एम ऑल्सो CS, कंपनी सेक्रेटरी, माझा कोर्स कम्प्लीट झालेला आहे, मी त्यात तो लिहायचं विसरलो. तर बऱ्याच अभ्यास करत गेलो आणि त्यातून खरं तर शिकत गेलो, आणि त्याच्यामुळेच मी तुमच्यासमोर आज बऱ्यापैकी मांडू शकतो. अभ्यासाची आवड आहेच मला, अँड यु नो आय गो थ्रू, आय ट्राय टू लर्न सम न्यू थिंग्स अँड ट्राईंग टू इम्प्रूव्ह माय सेल्फ थ्रू न्यू थिंग्स.
आय हॅव ऑल्सो लाईक 3 degrees.
ओके,
BSc 3 degrees from Pune NSD.
Okay, which are they?
BSc and MCA, and also I'm B.Ed.
Okay, all the best, and I hope, I want to see you as a doctor, so accordingly you proceed and get it done.
Okay, thank you sir.
Everyone doctor. I want to call you everyone.
Thank you sir, thank you.
Yes.
Sir, तुम्ही जे क्वेश्चनरी आता दिली ना त्याच्यावरनं खूप क्लिअर झालं, जे क्वेश्चन डिस्कस केले होते त्याचे लिंकड स्केल आणि बाकीच्या गोष्टी, त्याच्यात खूप मदत झाली.
थँक्यू. काय अडचण असेल तर विचारा, आणि
हो सर,
कीप इन टच, टच मध्ये राहा, ते महत्वाचं आहे. आपला ग्रुप असाच राहील, काय शंका नाही. येस
थँक्यू सर.
ओके थांबायचं.
ओके थँक्यू सर.
ओके थँक्यू सर.
या ऑलरेडी इट इज व्हेरी लेट फॉर यू. थँक्यू सर.
यस मॅडम. ओके ओके. सो आई एम गोइंग टू बी वेटिंग एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू यू लीव द मीटिंग व्हिच विल बी इन टच थ्रू आवर ग्रुप एंड ऑल. थँक्यू व्हेरी मच. ओके बाय बाय.
थँक्यू सर.